Morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. I pressure cooked the oxtail. I got the grease out of the fluid. It separated. I can show you. And now we're going to be making the tomato sauce. So we're going to use about an onion and a half. I have half of a red in the refrigerator. I'm just going to finish it off with this one. If you have a large onion, I think that would be more than enough. I'm not chopping, I'm actually going to put it in slices. I use a lot of vegetables when I make my tomato sauces. Make sure you cut your celery slices really thin, or you'll find they stay really, really chunky. And if you don't like the strings, by all means, you can remove them. I don't. I leave them. Now, if I don't use all the fluid of the oxtail, I'll save it and use it as stock like everything else. No reason to waste it. I'm going to put about 5 garlics in here. No, 6, my mistake. But you can put 5. These were very small, so I'm going to use more. This is going to be a bit spicy because I'm putting a couple of hot peppers in here. I had some dehydrated bell peppers. I threw them in some hot water. They're going in here too. If you don't see it, I will be putting them in. I will dice the tomatoes up because I'm not going to take the skins off. Though my aunt always, even for a salad, she took the skins off. She said, I hate the skins of the tomatoes. I whenever she, I don't care what she used, if it was a tomato, it would get peeled before she would cook with it. And I'm using maybe 2-3 tomatoes. I haven't decided. I took 3 out, but I'm still chopping. Looks like 2 is going to be enough. All right. Now you're going to have to mix, I mean really chop these hot peppers. If you're putting them in, chop them very, very fine. You don't want anybody to get a big piece of it. It'll burn your throat. And if you're unaccustomed to handling them, be careful with your fingers, because it's going to take a couple of hours, unless you're washing dishes and stuff, before the heat comes off these fingers. I'm putting 2 in. I think 2 would be just enough. I don't want it so hot that, you know, we're scorching our throats. Yeah, I can smell it. 2 is more than enough. You can also make a curry out of oxtail, but you have to prepare them before you make the curry. I'll show you how I do that another day. All right, I don't need that tomato. Now the water will be saved, like everything else, and I will use it to cook as well.
as many vegetables as I have in it, it will cook itself done. Because we're sauteing all of them right now before I add the stock and seasonings and get the flavoring up.
And we're going to need butter for this too,
to take some of that heat out.
Take a couple of minutes and I'll be back.
Okay, let me turn you so you can see more of this.
You can smell it. I would give you the amounts, but this is more a judgment what you're going to do. That's why I'm not telling you how much oregano. Whatever you put in of oregano and basil, use half the thyme because thyme has a stronger flavor to it. Help you with the ratio. Some bay leaf in it. Not that much. And your salt to taste.
sauce, the more butter you have to put into it, all right? That's pretty much how I learned from my husband, because he made a lot of curries. It all fits in the dinner, huh? Get another shot. Not wait to have this. I have not had this in over 10 years. So it's been a long, long time. I make different spaghettis, but I just hadn't made it in an oxtail. It has a lingering heat on it. We'll be putting cheese on it also. The meat is just coming off, which is really nice. So when we go to eat, the bone marrow will come out of the bones. And I use the water or the drippings if you wish, or this liquid, whatever you're gonna call it. I call it drippings. This smells so good. I can't tell you how good it smells. Basically, the only thing left is to make the spaghetti and the salad. I've got the dressing over there already because I made that last week. Simmer a bit, but anyway, that's how I make oxtail in a hot, let's say, I'll just say a tomato sauce, because you can make it mild, or you can make it hotter, however you wish, but anyway, that's how I make my oxtail in a tomato sauce. Take care. Bye-bye.